Hey guys, here we go into my final film study and prediction video for Canelo versus Golovkin, which is tomorrow. I'm super excited. The weigh-ins were dope. Triple G looked way more shredded, in my opinion, than he has before. And I'm excited. I'm excited about the fight. Are you guys excited? So there are a few things to talk about first. There were a lot of things that Canelo did in the first fight that I think are going to be very effective for him. One of those things is throwing combinations. The first thing is one of my keys to victories for Golovkin is, and we'll go over all this footage. One of the keys to victory for Golovkin is punching with Canelo, in my opinion. Canelo got credit for a lot of punches that Golovkin was able to slip and block and move, but it's so hard to judge. All you can see is that Triple G is being controlled by Canelo. And what I mean by that is as soon as Canelo starts throwing punches, pop, 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 right? Golovkin just goes like this, and he's not able to do what he wants to do. So in those moments, Canelo has control, right? And it appears, even when only half those punches might land, or only one of those punches lands, that Canelo is being really effective. And I think that that's going to be something that's really consistent throughout the fight. Now, these are some clips of Triple G defending himself against Martirosyan in their fight that shows that he's still not looking to make his opponents pay for throwing combinations at him. His strategy is still to kind of shell up. If you notice, his gloves are a little higher when he's blocking the shots. As you see here, his gloves are a little higher. But he's still not countering, right? And he's still moving back. And as you see, Martirosyan feints him, sees how he's going to react to the punch, sees that he's not countering, and then goes to the body and lands a great shot. All the way up until the scene right here where he throws a combination, is able to catch. And a lot of people thought he hurt Golovkin. I don't think he hurt Golovkin, but he was able to catch him with several clean shots and really back Golovkin up, catching him by surprise, which shows that that's not something that Triple G worked on. So it's not going to be something that's going to, very likely not going to be something that happens in this fight. Although I think it is absolutely paramount for Golovkin to stop Canelo from throwing combinations at him. It's too flashy, it eats up too much time, and Canelo, he can steal rounds by doing that just several times throughout the round. The same thing that happened with Danny Jacobs. Danny Jacobs would throw combinations, and Golovkin would kind of just try to pick him off. And that's going to put Canelo really far ahead. And I think I gave round one to Golovkin, round two to Canelo, and round three was pretty close. I gave it to Golovkin as well, but rounds like round number two are, if Canelo has worked on his spacing, right? If he's learned how to control Golovkin, feint him a little more, make him think those combinations are coming, and expend less energy, he can get the same kind of output as throwing a combination at Golovkin. He can get these reactions from Golovkin. And notice Golovkin's not scoring right here. Martirosyan's not scoring either. He scores here, right? But you can create space, right? So, like, what I mean by space, right? So the clock right here is at 27 seconds, right? It was at 27 seconds at the beginning of this clip. Wow, 27 seconds. He feints him, and then Golovkin moves back, right? Eats up 2 seconds. Then he feints him, and then goes to the body. Eats up 5 seconds, right? 5 seconds total, or 4 seconds, right? If he does that 10 times in the round, he eats up 40 seconds of the clock, right? And he can do more. He can do more feints. He can do more, just continue to do that. Maybe he does that every 10 seconds and he's able to eat up 3, 4 seconds, and stop Golovkin from being able to score punches or set punches, or more importantly, test Golovkin's defense. Feint him, probe him, right? If Golovkin is super worried about those feints and he's not countering them, that means that he has no opportunity to land offense during them. That means that instances like this, where Martirosyan feints Golovkin and then sees how he's going to react defensively, right? Feint him, he knows he's just going to bring his hands up and move back. Martirosyan is not only eating time, creating space from Golovkin, stopping Golovkin from throwing punches at him, but he's also able to test Golovkin's defense, do that again, and land a right hand to the body that Golovkin has no intention of defending or countering. And that's why I think it's absolutely paramount for Golovkin to have worked on this idea. If not, even if he's landing the bigger punches, even if he's, you know, for all intents and purposes, outboxing Canelo, and these shots are not effective, he's able to block and slip and do this, Canelo's going to be able to do that. He may be able to do that enough to just win the rounds. Oh, forgot to say, don't forget to subscribe to Wally Boxing. I don't know who the fuck that is, but very interesting that he has that in his clip. Getting back to the film study, it's going to be very important for Golovkin to punch with him and not allow stuff like this to happen, where people think, oh, now he's hurt. Oh, he hurt him, right? And then allow that to dictate whether or not he won the round because he got caught with a couple of shots that he wasn't ready for. It's looking like Golovkin's going to be in for a long night in terms of that. The second thing that I want to talk about is Golovkin's answer to Canelo's turning away and moving away from the right hand. As you saw in the first fight, there were a lot of instances like this, where Golovkin was just barely missing with his shots, barely missing. And notice he does step a little bit with his shots, right? A little bit of stepping. This one has a little bit more stepping in it, right? And then this one has a lot more. He goes from, if you look where his position of his feet is right here in the circle, right? The white circle on the mat, following Golovkin to his front. His back foot winds up basically being in the circle. But if you look at it, when he throws his first jab, Canelo counters, and then he starts jabbing forward and moving forward. After Canelo has already finished committing to his shot, Golovkin tries to catch him with the two-piece. If you look, and again, it's after Canelo has already shot his shot, Golovkin uses his jab to step forward and throw the shot. If you look at this clip right here, Golovkin is already preemptively stepping with his shots, not waiting for the punch to come, and closing the distance on his opponent. As you can see, when he shoots the second one, he's still closing the distance, not waiting for the shot to come, but closing the distance, shooting the jab here, and then coming under, and then landing the right hand over the top, shoots the jab, and as he's shooting the jab, the counter comes out, and he's shuffling forward during that, not waiting to see if the counter comes. He already knows that Martirosyan is looking to defend himself with the jab, but as you see, this is a perfect example. Shoots the jab, rocks back, and comes forward with his own jab while closing the distance, not waiting for the jab or seeing, and then stepping forward after the second jab with his right hand, but shooting the jab, rocking back from the counter, and then stepping forward with the next jab so he can get in position to land his counter. And then again, when his opponent starts throwing punches at him, he's not countering right there. But shooting the jab, not waiting for the counter, not waiting for his opponent to basically move away, right? And that was what Canelo was doing so well, is getting away from the shot. He would shoot the jab, boom, and then move out the way. But now he's, whoops, I don't know why it went so far back, but he starts shooting the jab and seeing if the counter comes, but stepping forward with it, boom, and slipping that shot as he rolls in, kind of getting back to the old Golovkin because he used to do this. Now shooting the jab here and then following his opponent to the right side and coming in with the hook. So it shows that he's definitely thought about the fact that he couldn't catch Canelo with those shots because Canelo was turning and moving away so much. My suggestion is still to go to the body. There were still a lot of opportunities in the early rounds where Canelo would see the right hand coming and he would just duck it. He wouldn't even move out of the way like that. He would just roll it, boom, duck, and move out the way, but he was still in range. So this tactic might not even be as effective as Golovkin thinks it's going to be against Canelo. But as we see in this next clip right here, he shoots the jab, he knows the counter is coming back, and as he shoots the jab, he rocks forward and then comes in with the uppercut. He doesn't land that one, but he's not shooting it and then moving in with the right hand. He's moving in off of the jab. As you see here, now he baits it, and he takes a step with the right hand, boom, after he baits the jab away from his opponent to land that great shot right there. And now he's going to shoot the jab and then rock forward off the jab and then land the uppercut. Again, small adjustments, a little bit of timing stuff, and he's able to land that shot. And then this one again, whoops, shoots the jab, rocks forward, not waiting for the counter, and then he's able to catch him while he's trying to counter. So a little bit different of a timing this time, not re-jabbing after the counter comes to set the shot up for the 1-2, but looking to close the distance and stop Canelo from having the same effectiveness of turning away from the shot simply by closing the distance, boom, and then landing his great shots. But so those are some of the adjustments that Golovkin is looking to make. As far as a prediction, I think the first couple rounds are going to go to Canelo. I think he learned a lot about Triple G, and it's going to make Triple G look more limited because Triple G is very smart. He's very cerebral. He fights with his mind and not his fists. If you guys watched any of the buildup, most of you did. He's very smart. He picks up on patterns really well, and that's going to allow Canelo, in my opinion, to kind of pull ahead early. He might win the first 2, 3, or even 4 rounds, but I think eventually Golovkin's going to pick up on the patterns, and he's going to really be able to start landing some good shots. And as we saw in the buildup, it takes Canelo a little longer to make adjustments than it does Golovkin, and when he's thinking about adjustments, when he's looking to set them up, he's moving backwards. He's not able to be effective, and that puts him behind on the scorecards. Now, if Golovkin's being for real when he says at the weigh-in, this is going to be a special treat, maybe he's just going to come in there and try to blast Canelo out. Maybe he's going to go to the body. Maybe he's going to do something. But I do give the edge to Golovkin. To be honest, though, I think Golovkin's looking a little, like, he was shredded at the weigh-in, but I think with his first fight, he was just so big. Like, look at these clips. Like, look at how big he is. He's massive, you know? And then in his fight with Martirosyan, look at how much smaller he looks here. I think that the fact that he knew that the IBF wasn't going to enforce the weigh-in, he came in bigger. That's why people thought in the first fight that he was fat, you know, he wasn't going to make weight. It's because he knew he didn't have the second day weigh-in, so he could rehydrate to however much he wanted, so he could just be bigger, cut more water weight, but just be bigger. And I think in this fight and in the Martirosyan fight, he decided to come in a little smaller for a little bit more speed, a little bit more, as you see in the clips with Martirosyan. And Martirosyan's a pretty quick fighter, but he's looking to leverage that speed and that footwork. As you see, if you watch his feet, look at how in and out he is. Bop, bop, in and out, and how, like, nimble he is on his feet and able to bop, boom, and then just really talented. But I think he's going to be looking to leverage that more to combat the athleticism of Canelo and to combat his defense. Because Golovkin was probably just a little bit too big in the first fight to really make use of it. I think he actually maybe thought that Canelo was going to really try and fight him and not just outpoint him. But I am officially picking Golovkin. I wouldn't be surprised, though, if with Golovkin coming in a little bit smaller, Canelo improving his punch technique like I showed in that video. And I want to address that. There were a lot of comments. You can't teach a new technique. That's not how it works, guys, right? It's just learning. It's relearning how to throw a punch, right? And if I'm going to demonstrate that a little bit, if you have a problem turning your hips over, right? So you can't really see my feet. I don't know how to do this. Give me a second. So I'll go ahead and put it on my feet. I don't know if it'll be able to get down there. Yeah, a little bit, right? Let me move this chair away. So if you're here and you're in position and you're throwing your left hook, right? Boom, and you're just turning. And this is, if you go back and watch a lot of Canelo's training videos, when he throws his left hook, he just goes like this, boom, and he'll have his hips go like this, right? Bah, right? And he'll move his hip into it, boom, right? Bang. But he doesn't turn his feet over, right? And if you see, right, I can't turn into the punch anymore than as far as my hips go, right? So there's going to be this weird power loss that you generate or that you lose. And so when you throw your punches, you're going to be punching right here because this is where all the snap is, but you're going to be hitting a target here. So you're going to go bam, and then you hit right here. So the target, what you're really, what the real, the most impact is going to be much shorter. So if you go back and rewatch that video, you're going to see that it, he has a lot of force coming in right here, and then he just moves his hand into the target. Boom. So it looks like this, right? And all the power is right here. Wham, wham. But if, but now that he, it looks like he's worked on his feet and his hips. And again, getting on my feet, right? When you turn into that shot, right? Boom. Now your hips can come through with you, right? So you're doing this instead, right? Just a little bit, boom, right? Your punches are going to be looking like this instead. And he's going to be turning through those shots much better. So here's the target, boom, right? Wham. That right hand, boom, go through. Wham, boom, boom. And you'll really be able to get your weight into it. And notice I can do all this while talking to you. It doesn't take any energy because all of the weight, all of the power is coming from my weight and not me throwing my punches like all that garbage. But you're just turning into the shots. And so it's not a new technique. It's just he's refined his punch technique. So I wouldn't be surprised if he's actually able to be a little bit more fluid and actually hurt a smaller Golovkin. Because like I said, Golovkin's used to having that that IBF second day weigh-in. So he's never been a big welterweight or a big middleweight. Remember like how big Danny Jacobs was? Holy crap, he was massive. But but now, like in the other fight, like look at how much smaller he is compared to how big he was in the first fight with and I'm pretty sure that that's the case. I really don't think he looks even nearly as big. Man, he's so freaking, yeah, look at this difference in his back size right there and then right here. He just looks so much bigger. But so he might be able to actually hurt a smaller Golovkin. And if that's the case, if it does wind up being a war, and that power check, like that technique, right? You're just so much quicker and you're just so much sharper. I think that there's a chance, to be honest, like seriously honest, I think there's a chance that Golovkin, might get hurt in this fight. I don't know if it would be to the body or I don't know if it would be to the head, but I think that Canelo's better technique. He's going to be out to prove something. I'm not counting him out by any stretch. Like, even though I'm picking Golovkin, I think that Canelo's a very live dog. And we saw that he knows how to make adjustments. He knows how to set traps. And if he's got better technique, another one, like for his uppercut, right, when his opponent is coming in, right, he wasn't turning his hips. And he would just come straight up with the shot. If he's got better technique on that, right, and he's landing that shot, that same shot, boom, and he can turn that over, right, boom, and go all the way over with it, carry his weight from his right side to his left side, he really might be able to hurt Golovkin and catch him with that, especially because Golovkin likes to duck down. You know, he's got that craft where he shoots the jab like this, boom, he hides his chin like this, right, boom, comes forward. Lord, boom, you know, moves forward. How does he do that shit, man? He's really coordinated. How do you do that? Let me see. Boom. Bam. Boom. Bam. Boom. I don't know. But he's really coordinated. Really talented. But he might be susceptible to his own, to the own uppercuts. And that also might be something that Golovkin is looking to do against him, because I don't know if I've ever seen Golovkin use an uppercut before. The Martirosyan fight, or a right-handed uppercut anyway. So it might be something that he's trying to do against Canelo as well, for reasons I don't know, because he usually kept his head pretty straight up. But God, I gotta work on my posture. But anyway, I'm picking Golovkin. I'm picking Golovkin to win. I can't wait to see what adjustments each fighter makes and how round 13 goes. I do think actually both fighters are going to be completely different, and I can't wait to see how it turns out. More importantly than my prediction, I'm just excited to see the fight, you guys. And I'm really, I know like a lot of people think I'm a Canelo hater. I'm not picking Canelo to win. But to be honest, I really wouldn't be surprised if he had enough power now to hurt Golovkin and then maybe outbox him. I'm not guessing that it's going to happen, but I think that the signs are there for him to be able to do that, or at least make it a really, really competitive fight, not just a run-a-thon, like the last half of the fight was, where he would fight in spurts. You know what I mean? Not saying he ran. But not fighting in spurts. I think he might actually be able to maybe work the first like he did in the first three rounds, work like in the he did in the first three rounds and make it a really good fight. I guess I should watch the weigh-in again, see how much bigger Golovkin might have been than Canelo. I don't remember actually. I was just too excited. I was just like, what's going on? I was freaking out. But my prediction is Golovkin. I do think he's gonna get it. It might even be by knockout. Obviously he has the skills and the talent and the power and the smarts to do it, but both of them do. Both of them do. But I think that if it's gonna come down to who has more control over there, the fighter. If Golovkin comes out and he's just keeping his hands to himself and he allows Canelo to throw punches at him and he doesn't counter them. He's gonna be in for a long night. He's gonna be made to look old. Everyone's gonna think he got old overnight. But if he comes out probing at the beginning of the Martirosyan fight, he does that with Martirosyan when Martirosyan's trying to control him. He just comes out, bah, huh? What's up? Setting it up, getting Martirosyan to keep his hands to himself. I think that he has a great chance of stealing the night and really having putting in a dominant performance. I'm super excited. Oh man, you know what? I might not even get to watch it live, you guys. I can't even believe this. My sister just told me today that she's coming in town to visit. I was supposed to go visit her before school started again. But man, the timing just didn't work out super well. But I don't know. Maybe I can trick her into going to watch the fight with me somewhere. But so I might not get to see it live. Oh man, I'm so excited. Anyway, that's my prediction. I'm going with Golovkin. I think there's a good opportunity for him to knock Canelo out. Canelo showed like a pretty great chin, but in the first fight, but I'm just not sure it's gonna be there this time. I'm just not sure. I also think that Golovkin is gonna be smaller as well. I think that's gonna be part of the strategy. We'll see. Maybe he just balloons up. He looks as big as he did in the first fight. But anyway. Man, I'm so excited. I'm just rambling. This was supposed to be a 10-minute video. Ha. Anyway, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. And yeah, look for my post-fight breakdown. It's gonna come. I'm gonna do my best to record the video or record the fight if I get to watch it live. If not, if you guys wanna like pirate that, get it up on Daily Motion for me. You know what I'm saying? Oh shit!